Hi everyone, this video is going to be an explanation of my Red-Day-DCA strategy. It's going to include all the maths behind it and will give you an actionable plan moving forward if you were to implement this strategy. So the top of the screen here represents the monthly chart for Bitcoin. This is the Bitcoin US dollar chart on the one monthly. And I discussed the idea of looking at any time the price action is below the 21 moving average. You can measure the amount of time it took to then come out of that moving average area. And that was 396 days. You can see that time period on the weekly chart just below is also highlighted. And the idea of this strategy is to be consistently buying only below that line. But when do you buy? Because you don't just buy every day, because not every day is a great opportunity. Depending on how zoomed out you like to be, you either buy only during months that are red. So on this monthly chart on the top, you only buy on the instances below the line where there is a red candle below the line. So 7 opportunities to do so at the bottom of this 2015-2016 market. And the calculation you need to do basically is you take 100% of your capital that you've got. So look at that as 100%. Then you look at the amount of opportunities that you've had in order to buy, aka how many red candles were there below the line. For the monthly chart, there were 7. So you would take your 100%, divide that by 7. In this instance, it was 14.2% per red monthly candle that you would have allocated into whatever projects you felt. If we now move over to the opportunities that we had on the monthly chart in 2018, about 210 days there available. How many red candles on the monthly chart existed there? So there was 1, 2, 3, and a 4th red candle. And that's quite easy maths because you've got 100% of your capital and there were only 4 opportunities to buy. So every time there's a red candle, you allocate 25%. So the problem is that it's quite a difference between 14% every time and 25% every time. But this should help. So we've got between 210 days and 400 days that these below the line moments tend to happen. And that would bring us to this range that you see on the bottom here, anywhere between November 2022 and May 2023. That's the kind of range we have left in this area. And we've already had 2 red candles on the monthly chart that have happened already. This is why I think the monthly chart to be doing this red day DCA strategy doesn't really work, because ultimately you're allocating too many funds in too few opportunities. So when you go to the weekly chart, you give yourself more opportunities to be buying because obviously there's more weeks than months. And on the daily chart, it's to a higher degree. So the closer you get to the daily chart, the more like dollar cost averaging this strategy is and the more involved you are. So it swings in roundabouts. You have to find out where you stand on that scale. Because if you're someone who wants to step away from it, maybe the weekly or the monthly chart is quite a good thing to be looking at here and acting on. But if you like to be involved and you like to be quite active and seeing the prices that you're buying at every day, then the daily one would be more your speed. And now below you have the daily candles for these same time periods. And you can see how involved you would have to be purchasing every single red day. Although I think this is probably, if you like dollar cost averaging, this is a really good strategy to be using the daily one and only be buying your tokens on red days during the times that we are below the 21 moving average on the monthly chart. Essentially what that will do is get you a lower average entry price than if you just bought every day, right? It's just simply a better strategy. So during that time period, there are actually 190 days under the 21 moving average where you would have entered the market. And that is out of a possible of basically about 400. That's around a 0.5% allocation every single red day during that time period. So depending on the amount of capital that you've got to the side, that is either worth it or it's not worth it based on trading fees and stuff, which is just simply why I really think the weekly chart is the good one to look at here. And even though it's called the Red Day DCA strategy, it's more focused on the week. On the daily chart, you're allocating around 0.5% of your available capital every red day. On the weekly chart, you're allocating about 5% every single red week. And on every red month, you're allocating between 14 and 25% every single time. How many red candles do we typically see below this line? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 on that occasion. 1, 2, 3, 4. So between 4 and 7 candles we see down at these levels. We've already had 2. And so the calculation to do here is between 50% and 30% of the funds that you would have typically already invested with this strategy should have already been placed in. So you have to incorporate that into how much you enter into the market with on a percentage basis. So for example, if you're using the daily, instead of allocating just 0.5% every red day, maybe at this point you have to be allocating closer to 1% daily, just because of the time duration that we have left below this line. If you're on a weekly, you might want to be allocating more like 5% instead of 4%. And on the monthly, you might want to be allocating now between kind of 25% and 40% every single time, because there may not be that many opportunities left. Depends on the cadence that you're looking at. I'm really enjoying this strategy because it takes the best parts out of dollar cost averaging and the best parts out of macro view analysis and combines them together to make this. I think it's extremely useful. The moves that we're making now below this line are ultimately going to be the things that get us to where we want to go in the next bull run. Anyway, I thought that'd be useful for everyone to have. And if there's ever any questions, feel free to DM, put it in the chat, in the comments, wherever you want. I will do my best to respond. What I'm going to do from now on, and this was suggested by a member, thank you, John, is that every time I see a red week get printed, I will let the members know. I think that's a useful thing to know, especially if you're following this strategy and you're only investing below the 21 moving average. I want to know when the weeks to be investing are and the weeks to not be investing are. I think it's quite useful. Anyway, thanks for being here. Stay emotionless, and I'll see you in the next one.